Update on Phoebe, the Toyota Echo Coupe, getting a Scion XA rear seat installed. While my drill is cooling off. So I had to take this panel off so that I could better access what's going on back here. That's the latching portion of the seat. Right now it's a self-tapper. I'm not sure how much I trust having just a self-tapping screw going into the side of the vehicle. So I might do a nut and bolt sort of thing through there. But it is attached-ish. The hinge is finally done down here. I used a step bit to drill in there. And then I used the XA bolt and built on little thick washer thing here. And some nuts from Napa Auto Parts so that I could attach it here inside the fender. And then once that is good and tightened, right now it's just kind of hand tight on there so that I can take this thing back off once I'm ready to put the panel on and cut around, because obviously where it's sitting now, the plastic panel doesn't have a cutout, so I'll have to kind of cut in a slice for where that is, and I'll have to get this adjusted just right to fit where I need it. Obviously, just one screw, it's a bit of a wobbly thing. But in any case, that is the progress there. In terms of the bottom portion of the middle portion of the hinge down here, I will do self-tappers there as well. And fortunately, I'll show you where we're looking under the car. That is where the V-brace and seat hook for the bottom cushion is mounted, so you're not going to, you know, puncture anything down here by drilling through. So, like with the wheel well, I'm going to use some spray-on bed liner, coat it really nice and thick to keep it from you know, moisture, stuff like that, getting in there too easily. Make it a little more secure that way. Got Black Widows living here. So I'm frustrated. I know that, you know, I need to do some I should have done this on my own, but somebody put my springs on upside down, and it's driven me nuts for years. And eventually I'm going to flip them. But the reason I know they're upside down, other than the shape from when they were originally, when they were installed, is, not that you can see it right now, they actually say Eibach, but they're upside down, because Eibach is upside down. So, yeah. The other thing I realized today is they didn't put the rubber isolators on the bottom portion. You can see them up here on the top, but not on the bottom, which is also annoying. And what was the other thing that was... Oh, yeah, the other thing I noticed today is my rear beam bushings are blown. So at some point, I will be upgrading to the polyurethane, because one of our members, Michael Lindsley, has polys on his Echo, which is lowered on, I believe, Tanes. And it's really not that bad. So yeah, why not? And that way it's not going to do this as quickly. But that is for a later time. I'm also going to be looking at getting a brace from Ultra Racing, because they're the only ones who have it readily available right now, where it bolts up to this part of the frame where the control arm goes to, and then connects over here at this brace. And not that mine is perfectly flat. My dad did that back in the early 2000s before I was driving this thing. Ooh, that's not looking good. Phoebe, you're starting to get worse. I'm probably going to spray that adhesive area. Things I don't like about my job is I start seeing things with my chassis joints. Anyway, so that's what's going on so far.
But it's actually going smoother than I thought it would.